एंड अ वेरी स्पेशल गेस्ट आउटसाइड रेलवे, श्री पवन कुमार अग्रवाल, स्पेशल सेक्रेटरी लॉजिस्टिक्स डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कॉमर्स, ही इज विथ अस टूडे. सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी टाइम आई वुड लाइक टू स्टार्ट दिस सेशन बिकॉज इट्स गोइंग टू बी अ लॉन्ग सेशन एंड आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट चेयरमैन रेलवे बोर्ड श्री वी के यादव टू काइंडली स्टार्ट द प्रोसीडिंग्स.
Good afternoon to everyone, and I welcome all of you, and I'm grateful that you could join us today at a very short notice. I also welcome Mr. Pawan Kumar Agarwal, Special Secretary Logistics, and today Mr. Purnendu Mishra, Member Traffic, and Mr. Rajiv Chaudhary, GM Northern Railway and North Central Railway. They are also with me today. And today we wanted to brief you on railway freight, and it is a very happy day for us that today we have achieved the freight loading which is even more than the freight loading last year. So it gives really pleasure to us that under this COVID situation, when there is a lot of issues involved, still with lot of efforts of all the officers and employees of Indian Railway and the type of motivation they have shown and the type of work had been done, especially in regard to infrastructure, removing the bottlenecks, improving the speed, average speed of freight trains, and above all consulting the stakeholders. All these things has brought a very good result today that we have been able to get a freight loading which is higher than the last year, and we are on the right path. And basically we is focusing getting a significant improvement in freight loading. Honorable Prime Minister has been emphasizing time and again for making Atmanirbhar Bharat, and also Indian Railway has really extremely good job in converting all these challenges into an opportunity. And in line with the government focus on logistics, we have been talking to all the departments, including Special Secretary Logistics, and we are making effort how to bring efficiency in logistic operation, bring competitiveness, how to bring down the cost of logistics so that the Indian industry can get benefit. As I mentioned, COVID period, Indian Railway has taken number of steps, and the most significant step was that we converted this challenge into opportunity. We were not running the passenger trains, and therefore we had lot of traffic block available, and availing those traffic blocks, we completed more than 200 infrastructure works, and this has really given us the benefit in improving the average speed of our freight train. It has almost doubled. Before lockdown, our average speed was approximately 23 km per hour. We have doubled it, more than 45 km per hour. And we had a renewed focus on improvement in goods set. If we are able to increase the average speed of our freight train, and if we are able to reduce the detention period at terminals, that is loading and unloading terminals, by increasing the speed of loading and unloading at goods terminal, by improving the goods set, the turnaround of wagons will significantly increase. And that is what happened, that we have been able to increase the turnaround of our wagon. We developed business development units at all the divisions and zones. We started talking with all the stakeholders, and based on their requirement, we started developing our policy. We have been tweaking our freight policy wherever required, and member traffic will be giving you a detailed presentation. We have given many incentives, many discounts to see that competitiveness of logistics sector increases and we are able to provide the freight loading at a competitive rate and the most important thing at a very, very enhanced speed. Today, if someone is booking his freight with the railway, there is a guarantee that freight will reach within the reasonable period of time. So we have taken, and those include, I'll just summarize, those include removing the bottlenecks by completing more than 200 infrastructure projects which improve the mobility, improving the average speed of freight train, talking to stakeholders and providing incentives, concessions, discount, tweaking the policy so that there is an ease of doing business. Stakeholders are able to utilize this freight facility with great easiness. Then we have been able to improve the goods set facility. So all these steps which we have taken, it has really paid dividend, and we are going to increase our freight loading to a very, very significant level. And whatever increase in average speed we have achieved today, we are going to institutionalize it. We are going to change the way freight trains are run with zero speed, zero based timetabling, as I have mentioned to you earlier also. This time we are going ahead and we are going to announce a zero based timetable. And that zero-based timetable will take care of a separate corridor for passenger, separate corridor of freight, and so that we will be able to maintain our average speed. Whatever average speed is there, we will be able to maintain even the post-COVID when we are going to introduce more number of passenger train. So that is certainly going to give us a lot of benefit.